Hello, dear friends. Today's video will be about fragrance from Christian Dior House Midnight Poison and dupes for Midnight Poison. My name is Svetlana. I live in Australia, in Western Australia, in the capital city of Western Australia, Perth. That's why my channel name is Perfumery. So this is a fragrance which I would like to talk about. The name is Midnight Poison. I have a version from the year of the issue, from 2007. You all know how to read batch codes. Normally Dior fragrances, they have a batch code exactly on the back. So if it's a front, this is a back. Normally it's here, it may be here. In this case, it's slightly on the side, so it's on the side of the bottle, starts with 7, which means it was issued in 2007. This perfume was in production from 2007 to about 2012. It was discontinued after the art director of the Dior house, John Galliano, left his position. I don't know whether discontinuation is related to his departure or it's a consequence of the bad sales. I don't know. The authors of this fragrance are Jacques Cavalier, who I love a lot, Olivier Crespe, who I love a lot, and François Demachy, the head of Dior House fragrance department or fragrance branch. I have an ambiguous attitude towards François Demachy, but he is a genius as well, and he is fostering a lot of genius perfumers, and he helps in bringing new fragrances to the world. This fragrance is consists of very simple notes. So if you look at its pyramid, you will find that there is nothing really special there. So it has citruses on top, mandarin orange and bergamot. It has rose, patchouli, amber and vanilla. Basically, it was a whole bunch of rose patchouli fragrances issued at the time, and I will talk through them now. Maybe it's not exhaustive list of similar type of fragrances, but it's very representative of the period. If you look back into the 2007, and if you find on the YouTube the commercial for this fragrance, I will put a link for commercial in the info box. You will find the whole concept of the fragrance. So that fragrance was issued as a symbol of youth and freshness. It's hard to believe at the moment. And if you look at the commercial, which was directed by Wong Kar-wai, who is a Hong Kong film director and the icon of art house movies, you will find that this fragrance is about Cinderella. But this Cinderella is coming to the ball. She's not leaving a ball in the midnight. She is coming to the ball at the midnight. And this Cinderella is not a typical young, tender girl wearing pink and light beige or pastel-like colors. She is quite strong. She is deep. She is sensual. And she is not running away from the ball. She is bringing herself to there, and whatever happens, she is there. The only similarity between Cinderella concept and Midnight Cinderella concept is that There is a uncertainty of what will happen after midnight. In case of Cinderella, traditional Cinderella, we await the situation that prince will find her. But in case of midnight Cinderella, it's a little bit of bringing unconsciousness to the ball, like I'm bringing full myself with all my deep senses to the ball. It's not a fragrance for the really young 17 years old woman. The interesting thing is that the commercial for this fragrance was considered as a study book for people making commercial. You even can find a video where they explain the concept, they explain the success, they explain everything. In this fragrance, it was positioned for women of 25, 35 years old. I assume that the original Cinderella was around 15 to 18 years old. Yeah. This is a sign of our time, of that time when women started looking for their prince much, much later in their life, not when they are 18. And when woman is 25, 35, she already has experience, she already understands her feelings, she already can manage her emotions, and she is not naive, yeah? She is more like very deep, and some say even there is a witchery side of this, and she understands her witchery feminine side. The notes, I don't remember if I said or not, the notes in this fragrance are very simple. There is a rose, citruses, amber, vanilla, and patchouli, of course. Some say this direction, some call this direction in perfumery as shipper, floral shipper, or woody shipper, or shipra, yeah, woody shipra, or floral shipra fragrances. But I would call them rose patchouli, because for me, to be a shipra, the fragrance need to meet three criteria, yeah, and these fragrances don't quite meet it, because, for example, this fragrance lacks the oakmoss, yeah, it's prohibited substance in perfumery, not prohibited, severely restricted, so the only very small percent of oakmoss can be in the modern fragrances, because it become allergic. So this probably is not for allergic people. It's very deep, it's very sensual. It has a fantastic projection, it has a fantastic longevity. And for some reasons it was discontinued in just about 4 or 5 years after creation. And can we believe that this fragrance had a bad success? I don't know. The advertisement was fantastic, the concept was fantastic, the evergreen in the ad, she looked great with her blue eyes. However, it was discontinued, and if you want to buy it now, it will cost you a lot of money. So what can you do to avoid it? You can try to replace it with something, or otherwise pay. Yeah. So I have 4 other fragrances today to compare it with Midnight Poison. And just to anchor ourselves in the concept of this fragrance, if you didn't try it, if you tried it, there is no need for you probably even to watch it. Yeah. Watch my video. This is a drama story. So it's clear, if this perfume was a movie, it would be a drama story. If this perfume would be music, it probably would be Beethoven music. Quite well done, classic and quite neutral. Yeah, if I can say that Beethoven is neutral, it's not neutral, it's drama. Yeah, his life drama, and this perfume also has a drama. I'm going to the first one, fragrance which can be considered as a dupe. This fragrance is from Lilac House, Lilac House in France, which makes glass art, and was very famous, making a lot of bottles for many fashion houses, for many perfumes. And this fragrance was about a cactus glass bowl, very famous glass sculpture by Lalique. And it was issued in 2006, 1 year prior Midnight Poison. So it was not a copy of Midnight Poison by Lalique. It was an independent fragrance created by completely independent concept. And the perfumer is Natalie Larson, the genius perfumer as well. What is similar in this fragrance and in Midnight Poison? So the similarity lays in the rose patchouli concept. However, this fragrance for me cannot replace the Midnight Poison because it lacks amber and it lacks vanilla. Also, it lacks the sweetness from citruses on top. So it's much colder, and it's colder and more like a rough, you know. If Midnight Poison is something, would be like a ball of stuff together, then this fragrance would be like with spikes, you know. And why is that? Because this fragrance also has pepper, black pepper, which is noticeable, vetiver, and actually oak moss. I don't know in how much oak moss is here, because it was created prior to IFRA reformulation, IFRA required reformulation. It has rose, it has patchouli, but it almost a medicinal and a comforting, a little bit green sounding. It's not even enough rose, not as much as Midnight Poison. Therefore, I would say it's not as thick and as warm. Midnight Poison, no warm at all. Yeah, but this one even colder. So Midnight Poison is more neutral temperature wise. I would not pick it as a clone. So it's in a similar direction somehow, because it's a rose patchouli, but it's not, it doesn't contain enough notes to be a clone for Midnight Poison. Yeah. However, I think it's more suitable for men because of vetiver, and it's not sweet. So I think it's fantastic, masculine side. I should not say men, because I don't think men cannot wear this one. Of course they can. Absolutely, yes. It's completely unisex. But this is more masculine. So more in the line of masculinity rather than femininity. Then going to the next one. Next one is from the house of Jean-Paul Gaultier, and name is Madame. This is Eau de Parfum. There is also Eau de Toilet of this version, of this fragrance, but it has a completely different note. So don't try to buy Eau de Toilet, buy Eau de Parfum if you want to buy this one as a rose patchouli. This fragrance was issued in 2007. They don't say who is a perfumier, but if you look at my video of Jean-Paul Gaultier house, many of their perfumes are made by Francis Courchard. So I would not exclude a chance that it's made by Kurkdjian, and it's a beautiful fragrance. It's also a rose patchouli, but it is a bit happier. So the pink pepper on top gives a little bit of juiciness, more juiciness than Pearls de la Lake, because Pearls is quite dry. And orange gives a sweetness. But this fragrance also lacks amber and it lacks vanilla. However, because it has a musk and woody on the bottom, it has a little bit of like an amberic sounding, a little bit. It actually smells less familiar, less similar to Midnight Poison than Pearls de la Lake. However, I'll tell you at the end of the video why this is important fragrance to compare with Midnight Poison. Yeah. Okay. Going to the next. And next one is Elle from Yves Saint Laurent. This fragrance also issued in 2007 by the same perfumiers which made Midnight Poison, Olivier Cresp and Jacques Cavalier. Seems they were a little bit cheating to Yves Saint Laurent, but they delivered a great job. Because from today's five fragrances is my favorite. So, if we compare it with Night Poison, then this would be happy end story of the woman who came to the midnight ball. So, if this is a drama and there is uncertainty of what will exactly happen with the woman, then this is a bad end story. This is a tragedy. And if this is a Beethoven, this is Bach. Very boo-boo-boo. No, Beethoven is boo-boo-boo. Bach is like classical music and a bit more orthodox than Beethoven, yeah? Then this one potentially would be like a story of the girl next door, yeah? She didn't succeed a lot, but she met a boy next door and they are happy, they have a dog and will soon have a baby. Then this one is a woman who succeeded at this ball. She actually met a prince. She also made a career. It's like probably Natalia Vodianova. She had a little bit of drama, then she had a success. Now she's married, a lot of kids, fantastic career, beautiful woman. Very optimistic story. What is different in this fragrance from this fragrance? What is the difference? Number one is sweeter. It also lacks amber and vanilla. So, because it lacks amber and vanilla, it's a little bit less deep than this and less sensual. However, it's replaced with notes of lychee and peony and also has a citruses on top. It's sweeter and happier, much, much happier. My mom loves this fragrance a lot. This is her favorite. And I think I have around probably four backup bottles, because we're both using them. And this is what she used actually. Ah, no, her fragrance is it. Her. This is what I used. That's a lot for me. So, if you are trying to find a clone for Midnight Poison, I would say this is the closest one from the designer fragrances. Yeah? Okay, going to the last one. Last one is a fragrance from Russia. I'm from Russia and fragrance is from Russia. And the name of this fragrance is La Belle de Russie. It's available on the eBay if you want. So, if you look at Fragrantica and you will see that The only similarity with midnight poison is patchouli, amber, and vanilla. They say it doesn't have a rose and it doesn't have citruses. It declares some strange notes like apricot, which probably I can feel here, and it gives a sweetness which citruses give here. It also has note of carnation, which I don't feel here at all, thanks God, because I don't really like carnation in perfumery. And lotus, which I don't feel either. So this is the closest clone of closest dupe to midnight poison. It smells almost identical. The differences are in longevity, in projection. For one spray of this fragrance, you need two sprays of this, and even though it will not sound the same. Also, they sound the same at a different time. For example, if you apply them on your wrists, then you will find that this one now smells like this one 1 hour ago, and vice versa. This one is not as deep as midnight poison. It's not doesn't last as long as this one. However, in the sounding, it's almost identical. It's much closer to midnight poison than everything I've shown you before. Therefore, I don't compare it with any music, any movie, because it's almost the same. So the difference is in, like, if this music was Beethoven music was played by a symphonic orchestra, this one was played by a much reduced orchestra in much smaller city than this, probably New York, and this would be somewhere in one small town somewhere where there's an orchestra. So this is my verdict. They are very similar. The only problem with this fragrance, some say that the brand which produces it, the name is Novaya Zarya, or in French, Nouvelle Étoile, they are not consistent with the quality. So some say that to get a proper quality, like in the bottle I'm having now, the fragrance needs to wait up to 1 year. So you can buy it, and you never know how old the bottle you bought. It may be already old, so it will smell very similar to midnight poison, or it may smell complete mess. So if it's your case, just let it to stay for at least 9 months, 6 months, yeah, and then try again. So it should become become good after that. Doesn't look like a vintage wine, but see, the bottle look horrible. Yeah, it's like actually this fragrance is from 1980. It's very old. So it's strange that the fragrance created 40 years ago is so similar on the quality, comparing it with proper fragrance from you may see my previous videos. The early bottles of midnight poison, they have a special sealing here, so actually you can open the bottle, it's moving and it's leaking. So when you are buying online, ask your seller to ensure that it's not leaking, yeah, if you decided to buy this one. Then there is a trick which I watched from one of the bloggers. His name is just a moment please. His name is Sindri Guo. I assume he's from China, and he has a video on YouTube, where he's trying to mix fragrances to replace Midnight Poison. He has a Midnight Poison, so he knows what he's talking about. So what he's saying, why I mentioned this fragrance before, it's important. If you mix this fragrance with Estee Lauder Amber Mystique, then in proportion 1:1, so how you normally do it, you just spray them in one bottle, yeah? Then you may get a quality similar to Midnight Poison. I'm going to do it one day, but I didn't find the Estee Lauder Amber Mystique yet. So when I find it, I will try to mix them. He says this is a closest dupe to Midnight Poison. Then another source where you can potentially find it are those houses which produce popular fragrances in the oil form and even in the perfume-like form in the spray bottles. One of them is a Perfume Parlour in UK. I'm not sure if they have this Midnight Poison, but if you look at them, they normally make quite a good compositions very similar to originals. I didn't try in this particular one, and normally I do not support using such fragrances because I think it's they have an issue with intellectual property. But in case of fragrances, this is consumable product, and one day you finish your bottle, yeah, and there is no replacement for it. I don't think in this case using of such oils is a bad idea because they are not competing for the consumer with the creator of the fragrance. Yeah, it's similar like if you buy a print, if you like see the Picasso print in the magazine, and if you cut it and put in the frame, does it really goes into the conflict with copyrights of Picasso paintings? I don't think so. So if fragrance is still in production, then I really don't like it. But if it's completely discontinued like this one, then I don't see it's a big ethical issue. Then why this such a good fragrance was discontinued? I have this question because if you look at the Yves Saint Laurent, it's actually, you can still buy it. I just noted that it's discontinued in Australia only a few months ago, and now it's on sale or at online fragrance shops with at a discount, which for me it's a sign of complete discontinuation. If you still want to buy it, just buy it now because it's cheaper than retail price at the moment. And then the story with Midnight Poison may repeat with Yves Saint Laurent. Why this fragrance was successful and this one not? Some say this is better than Yves Saint Laurent Elle. I don't think so. I think they are both good. Normally they discontinue fragrances because they're not popular anymore. And if you go to the shops now, I don't think you will find a lot of fragrances with a similar rose patchouli concept. It's not in fashion anymore. And the young consumers, they prefer, young gay consumers, they prefer a different type of fragrances. Moreover, now there are a lot of experimenting with mixing the notes, and you can find a lot of things which are like, they don't smell like anything. Like, for example, if you take Mugler, if you try Alien Mirage, you will find it smells like nothing before, yeah, even though it reminds me a lot something, but I still cannot find what. So it's a lot of experimenting, a lot of new molecules were developed for perfumery, and it's lot of room for creativity. And I think these fragrances only appeal to those who have either nostalgic value of the fragrance, or who want to find something which is not in a mass market, like something unique. That's a sad story that is discontinued, but we know it's discontinued. So there are more things coming to the market, there are more new things, and people, younger people, people experimenting with fragrances, they find something even better than this. I personally don't think it's the best fragrance in the world. I don't think this is the best fragrance in the world for me. It's fantastic. For me, this one is better than this. My mom thinks it's the best in the world. You can decide whatever you want. Good luck in your search. Don't forget about Belle de Russie. Don't forget to try. Even if you don't like it, it's very cheap. So I will put in below this video all the names of the perfumes from today, and share with me, please, if you had this fragrance, if you had any of those fragrances, what you think about them, about similarities and differences. I will be very, very glad to hear from you. Thank you.